Hi there, welcome back to the channel. Thank you so much for tuning in. March marks a special date. It marks the 18th anniversary of Prince's 31st studio album entitled 3121, which is the address of his Los Angeles residence. This was the follow-up to 2004's Musicology, which was considered a comeback album. Little backstory, before 2004, Prince had changed his name to The Symbol. He was also known as the artist formerly known as Prince. He was releasing music on his own website, which was great for Prince purists, but for the everyday fan or for the masses, a lot of people thought he just kind of went away or disappeared. So 2004 was a return to the charts, to commercial radio, to giving him a really profitable tour. And 2 years later, he came out with 3121, which would become his last number one album while he was alive. This was his first number one album since 1989's The Batman soundtrack. There were numerous singles. I believe there was Fury, Te Amo, Corazon, and Black Sweat released off this album as singles. I enjoyed this album. It is a step a little bit above Musicology. A lot of people thought it was very generic, 2004's album, Musicology. I thought it was good. This was a little bit better. It doesn't expand his palette, but I'm going to say it kind of refines it. So we're back to ballads, funk, rock, dance. Nothing too out of the ordinary from Prince's repertoire. But he's still working on it. But he has nothing really to prove anymore. But he's showing you the musicianship he brings to the table. This album showcases it in style. We start off with the title track, 3121, which is a gritty funk number, which he brings back the Camille character from Sign of the Times, which is a welcome return, I thought. Lolita is a nice little dance track where he kind of talks about the girl Lolita, who's he's kind of saying no to her advances. Te Amo, Corazon is basically a Santana-esque style kind of song. Beautiful, I love it. Black Sweat is a sexy, funky song, kind of like a updated version of the song Kiss from Prince. Incense and Candles is another song. It's a beautiful ballad. It's about seduction. I like it. Love is a nice little dance number. It's good. Satisfied is a great standout track, a very Otis Redding sounding soul song. Fury is a rocker. The guitar playing has to be heard to be believed. And if you listen to the end, it will break your speakers. If you remember Purple Rain, the guitar is playing. This is in that vein. The Word is a nice song as well. I like it. I like this one. It's a neo, I would say a neo soul song. Beautiful, loved, and blessed with one of his proteges. I believe her name was Tamar at the time. The Dance is a great song where I think Prince really shows his heartache and everything about, it's kind of a, like I said, it's a dance between, he wants to be with this girl, he has a crush on her, but he goes, if I can't be your lover, I don't want to be just friends. I can't do that. It's either I'm all in or all out, and I get it. And you hear the heartache when he's kind of still dancing around the issue, if it's still going to happen or not. Get on the Boat is a great dance number, a great party number. This is how you start off a party with this song. I love it. Overall, this is a great, great album. Prince is in fine form. Like I said, he's not expanding the palette in any way, shape, or form, but he has refined it to an art, and nobody does it better than him. This is he's sorely missed, in my opinion. He's, you know, he's one of the greats, and this is a great album. It did well, but I think it deserves to sell a lot more than it did. I believe it sold over 1 million copies. It's a platinum album, but I think it should have sold a lot more. But I think a lot of people were expecting Purple Rain Part 2, and he's just not going to do that. Purple Rain is Purple Rain, and every album, like he said, every new album is like introducing a new friend. And this is a great new friend. 3121 deserves to be in your collection. If you're a Prince fan, you deserve to have this. You need to hear it once in your life. If, you know, Incense and Candles and Black Sweat doesn't get your mojo working, nothing will. So I recommend this for anybody who wants to bring their partner home and have a little bit of extracurricular activities. It's not a bad album to bring home. And that I miss Prince. This is one of my go-to albums of his latter-day material, and I can't say anything bad about it. It's a great album. It deserves to be in your collection. It's underrated, in my opinion. So please do yourself a favor. I think it has been reissued a couple of years ago. Search it out. It's worth having in your collection. I highly recommend it. This is Stephen from the Roundtable with my thoughts on Prince's 3121. We miss you, Prince. Wish you were back here.